to letter B. Let's see. B. Let's see. Match perfectly along. D. And tree to the fountain. Oh my goodness, this is a tricky one. Let's see here. Maybe like that. Oh my gosh. Guys, this is a little challenging. We will get the hang of it. There we go. Try again. On to E. Oh, it's a little bit loud, sorry. Okay. E. You know, this would be very relaxing. Not relaxing. This would be very relaxing to do while watching a movie. Something, watching a show, doing this, I would really enjoy that. Unfortunately, this sticker book is not actually mine, but I'm being graced with being able to do a page for you guys. I'd love to do the whole book, but it's not mine. I'd love to get one, but I'm not sure how much this was. My oma ordered it on Amazon as like a Christmas present from one of my cousins, and then this one is actually, don't worry, I'm not doing someone's Christmas present. This is actually my oma decided it looked really satisfying, so she wants to do it with her and my niece when she visits tomorrow. Tomorrow's actually my oma's birthday. So I'm totally gonna be down to do this tomorrow with my oma and my niece, but they're probably gonna want to do quite a few of these pages, and I'm sure my nephews will as well. There's not very many pages, there's only 10. I'm doing one, so it'll only be 9. So I wanted to make sure to do one for you guys because I thought it would be really satisfying. I mean, look, so far this was empty. Look what we have so far. It's so cute. Little porcupine. Porcupines are actually native where I live. And like pretty much every forest you go to. Which forests are about a 5-minute, 10, 15, maybe minute walk away from every part of where I live. So they're all over here. What we don't have is hedgehogs. I wish we did, but we have porcupines. Porcupines are cool too, native here, but hedgehogs only live in. Brown ones are native to Europe, and the white African pygmy are native. native to Africa. Those are generally the pets that people own are the ones that are from Africa. And the brown ones that are native to Europe are wild, and they're typically not pets. Like, people in Europe may adopt them as a pet. Not sure if that's legal or not, but you know how, like, damaged animals who don't have parents and, you know, will be left to die, people take them in. I was thinking some people probably do that in Europe as well, but the ones that are sold in pet stores are from Africa, the African pygmy. They're more docile, they're a lot smaller. The European ones are a lot larger, they're brown as well. And the other ones are typically white, but they can be seen in an array of other colors as well due to breeding. But this is titled as a porcupine, although to me it looks more like a hedgehog, but you know, whatever. A porcupine, fun fact: an average porcupine has 30,000 quills. Pretty cool. Another fun fact that I happen to know. Oh no, a little gap here. But another fun fact that I happen to know is that hedgehog and porcupines, obviously they can't be born with the quills, but they are. So how it's done in a way that it doesn't damage the mother, the quills have the fluid filled like skin sac around them, so that it protects the mother as they're being birthed. But they're born with a full set of quills. They're just under this little fluid skin sac covering the pokey bits. And then 45 minutes after they are born, that fluid dissolves, the fluid skin sac dissolves, and they have complete quills all over their body. Obviously because of self-protection, like a newborn porcupine or hedgehog is going to be needing that protection the quills provide, so I just thought that was really awesome when I found that out, because I was like, that makes sense when I heard that they're born with them, but I was like, but how is the mother able to birth them then? And this fluid filled sac. Nature is amazing, isn't it? Some of these could be a little tricky to not get any wake ups. Come on, dude, I'm trying my best here. I'm getting really thirsty. Need some water. See, we're about 9 minutes into the video of me rambling. I always watch ramble videos. They're my favorite. I love soft spoken, but I like whispering too. But rambling, like just hearing people talk, is the most relaxing to me, so I love reading videos. Obviously, the videos I make are the types of things I enjoy watching. So I'm hoping, you know, some of you will enjoy these videos. Maybe have the same taste as me. I know a lot of people are really into tapping. There's a few tapping videos I've seen that I really enjoy, but for the most part, it's not really a big trigger of mine. So it's hard to make tapping videos because I don't really know. It's something I don't enjoy. I don't really know, like, exactly how to do it correctly, I guess, but the tapping videos that I've made have actually done the best of all my videos, and the baby mouse videos seem to have done really well. I think you guys really enjoyed those a lot more than the other ones I've made, so I'll definitely be doing more tapping videos and continue the baby mouse series. Now that I'm on Christmas break, because I'm in school, and I was very, very, very busy. But now that I'm on break, I can be filming again. I'm on break for 3 weeks. 3 weeks. Awesome. So, yeah. Gonna make a lot of videos to post. Watch my videos and like fall asleep to them and helps them with their anxiety because ASMR is a big part of my life. It really helps my anxiety, sleep, and pain that I have issues with. So it really would warm my heart if people enjoyed these and they really helped them. But even if no one, you know, not many people watch these, I honestly just enjoy making them. It's really fun to me, it's a hobby. And so, I just, you know, I want to do this. So, I hope that these do help even just one person out there enjoys them. But, you know, that isn't the case, still fun to make, but I have a few people to watch ASMR regularly. This is one girl, she changed her username, so I can't remember what it is, but I know you're probably watching, and I love you. I think your username used to be like, I'm trying to remember, I'm really sorry. It was something I was unfamiliar with. I think it's maybe a movie quote or something, but it said, like, the only woman in the world, like, the most loved woman in the world, the only woman in the world, something like that. But then she, or I don't know if it's a she. I was assuming it for some reason, I guess, but the person changed the username. But I can't remember what it was for some reason. Okay. Have you guys had the Starbucks iced sugar cookie latte? Because I had that today. And I've been so excited to have it. I've been wanting to try it for so long. And my best friend, Kleena, she really wanted to try it too, but she doesn't like coffee. So I was like, Kleena, you can order it with milk instead of coffee and have like a yummy like milk drink. And she did. And she was like, this is so good. And she posted it and tagged me in it, and I was so happy. And this was today. We were both gonna like get them together because unfortunately she moved to another state and she's so far away from me and I miss her so much, but it's gonna be like a way for us to like get coffee together, kind of like order the same thing we never have. We're so excited, it's gonna be so sweet. Well, I go to Starbucks, and Starbucks is closed, so I go to another Starbucks location. It's open. I'm so excited. I order my drink. I get it. I taste it. It is disgusting. It is. They did not give me the right drink. They gave me a blonde iced caramel latte, and I hate blonde coffee. It is so gross. I don't know how you people drink that, second of all. Okay, no, but I'm probably sounding really mean. I'm sorry, guys. But second of all, I hate caramel. I know everyone loves caramel, but I really don't like caramel. And I could not drink it. I had to give it to my mom because I couldn't drink it. And I was so upset because I ordered the iced sugar cookie. And I was so excited. And I was going to enjoy it with my friend, Kalina. And I didn't even get it. But tomorrow, I might get one. I don't really know if we're gonna be near a Starbucks or not, because it's my mom's birthday, but I might get one tomorrow, hopefully. And they better give me the right order. Because at first I was like, is this just what it tastes like? But she said it was really sweet, and I watched reviews of people who really had it, and the way that they described it as like super sweet, the one that I had was like no sweet at all. Like all it tasted like was caramel and coffee with like no sweetener in it. Like the caramel wasn't even sweet, really. Like kind of like in a weird caramel, like with a blonde coffee aftertaste. So gross. And the thing is, I don't like my coffee very sweet. I don't really like sweet things, and I can't really handle sweetness that well. After I have like a dessert, I have to have a pickle or something salty afterwards, because I can't handle the sweet like taste in my mouth aftertaste. So it's not like I tasted a sugary drink and I was like, oh, this isn't sweet. It wasn't like that. They genuinely gave me someone else's order, and I think theirs was a sugar-free caramel blonde. Almost disappointing, because the woman in front of me took a sip of hers in the driveway and stopped, like she got the wrong order. I broke the pop. No, oh my god. But she stopped in the driveway, like she got the wrong order. And I'm like, I think that she got mine and I got hers. On the receipt thing, it had mine right, but it didn't taste right. So she probably took a sip and was like, this is way too sweet. I said sugar free, which is sad, because maybe she's on a diet, or maybe, like, you know, she has some sort of health condition where she, like, is trying to avoid sugar, and then she received mine. I mean, it's the holiday season, overworked, understaffed, so, you know, someone probably really tired, accidentally messed it up, you know. It's not too big of a deal. Like, I'm not really mad at the person who made a simple mistake. It's a little unfortunate, but, you know. I am really struggling at this. Okay. This is the last piece, guys. Our hedgehog, our porcupine is looking so cute. Oh my god, he did it! I'm gonna try to redo this piece though, because there's a little bit of white. I think some of the pieces just like didn't go in 100% perfectly, so there's gonna be a little bit of gap. Yeah. But it's still super cute. I love it.